Hi guys! Today I'm excited to talk to you about Don't Look Up. Now, this movie comes to select theaters on December 10th, and then it will hit Netflix on December 24th. And I gotta admit, I went into this cautiously optimistic. I thought it looked good, but I was definitely like, I don't know, it's like 2.5 hours long. Like, what is going on here? And I'm excited to talk to you about it. So let's dive into it. Now, if this is your first time here, I'd love it if you'd take 1 second and hit that subscribe button. Go ahead and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on any more videos like this one. Hey, Tessa from Mama's Geeky here. Thank you so much for stopping by my YouTube channel. Okay, guys, so all you have to do is take a look at this cast list, and it is very clear that there is a lot of potential here with Don't Look Up. What I will say is I went into it cautiously optimistic. The trailers had me excited, but not like super excited, not wanting to dive in. I couldn't really tell, is this serious drama, political satire, or is it like full-on comedy? What is it? Well, somehow it's both. It's all of the above, really. It's even a little bit of a thriller. There's some seriously intense moments. I mean, this thing is, it has no business being this good. Let's put it that way. The thing is, 2 hours and 25 minutes, that feels excessively long before you even go in. I've got to admit, I was thinking to myself, is this going to be worth it, okay? I had to drive 1.5 hours to the screener, and I thought, this is like a whole night, a full night, 1.5 hours each way, plus a 2.5 hour long movie. Is this going to be worth it? And I can say, without even question, that it was totally worth it. I was taken by complete surprise with this movie. I mean, the cast is amazing. Of course, you've got Leo DiCaprio and Jennifer Lawrence at the forefront. They're at the head of this thing. But they're not the only stars in this movie. There's a plenty of other incredible talent, like Jonah Hill, Meryl Streep. We've got Timothy Chalamet is in this. Like, what is going on? This cast is incredible. And I could go on and on and on. Cate Blanchett. I mean, come on. It's bananas, all the people that are in this movie. And they all have their moment to shine, okay? That's the best part about this. At the beginning, you get that time with Jennifer Lawrence's character and Leonardo DiCaprio's character. You get to see their relationship be forged. You get to learn that they're like a mentor-mentee relationship, okay? When Jennifer Lawrence's character discovers this comet and they quickly realize it's hurtling towards Earth, Leo DiCaprio is hilarious, right? He gets like sweaty and anxious and nervous. I mean, I think most people would. They decide to go see the president, who wants nothing to do with helping them. Is it gonna help her? That's Meryl Streep's character, the president. Is it gonna help her in the elections? No, like she doesn't want this out there. She doesn't want people panicking. She doesn't want people second guessing what she's doing. So she wants nothing to do with it. Now this is all very, very early on in the movie, and it just continues on and on and on. So I've got to admit, at this point in the movie, about half hour, 45 minutes, and I'm thinking there's still so much more to this movie. Is it going to be able to hold up and continue on? And it does. This movie is, it's hilarious. But it's also got this political satire and this all this stuff about government in there that I wasn't expecting it to be as intense as it was, despite the trailers. I really thought it was going to be like a subplot thing. But it's so good how it was done. Every single character, like I said, gets their moment to shine. They all have their moments. Someone that I thought was phenomenal in this is Ariana Grande, and I was actually really, really excited to see her join this cast. And I love that she has her own character, and she has a song, her original song in this, which is nominated for a lot of awards, and it's actually weaved into the storyline. Usually original songs are thrown over the credits at the end, but I mean, you've got to applaud the fact that they really made this a part of the story and a part of the film, and I loved her performance. It was incredible, and it gave me chills, I'm not gonna lie. But the movie overall is just a ton of fun. It's a little bit terrifying. It's definitely part thriller. I mean, you think, wow, would this be the response of the country, of the world, if a comet was hurtling towards Earth and had the potential to kill us all? Yeah, it could be. And that is what is absolutely terrifying. There's overlying themes here of humanity, right? Which is just like, this is what how humans act. Like here, this is them. There's a wide variety of it through all the different characters, but it feels real. It feels realistic. It feels like something that could actually happen. And of course, it kind of channels the energy of our country for the last year or two also, which is a little terrifying and a little scary. I mean, it dives in on science. It gets political, but I really thought the way it was done was smart. It was fun. And listen, like I said, the cast is amazing. They're so good. I loved every single character, except for the ones I'm not supposed to like. My only issue with Don't Look Up overall is that there is this one decision that's made, and it feels so out of character for that character, and it goes on for a little while, and it just kind of annoyed me. Like, When it first happened, I thought, oh, did I miss something that this character would make this decision? And I kind of waited to see if I had missed potentially a plot point, and I did not. So it just felt too out of character, and it was kind of annoying, and it was completely unnecessary, but it doesn't take away from the movie as a whole. There are two end credit scenes. There's a mid-credit scene and there's an end credit scene. Both are absolutely worth sticking around for. I hope you guys really enjoy them. I thought they were really fun, and they really tie stuff together, tie the whole film together. And it's just, it was a great movie. The cinematography and the editing was amazing. There's certain moments where stuff's going on and you just see close-ups of nature and close-ups of things that are happening. And I felt like that was a great way to kind of propel the story forward. For something that was 2.5 hours long, it never really dragged on. It never felt slow. There's a little moments here and there, but I think whenever it started to get that far, they would change gears and fix itself. So it was nothing that I could really fully complain about. It's an amazing cast. It's a lot of fun. It's hilarious. It's a little bit terrifying. And I hope you all enjoy it. It hits theaters on December 10th and then Netflix on December 24th. So if by the time you guys have gotten to this review, you've seen Don't Look Up, let me know what you thought down below in the comments. Let's chat. Be sure to give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on more videos like this. You can follow me over on Instagram and Twitter. I'm at Mama's Geeky over there. M-A-M-A-S. G-E-E-K-Y. Thanks, guys. Thank you so much to all of my monetary supporters, my members here on YouTube, as well as my patrons. If you haven't joined yet, please consider doing so. We have some really awesome perks, including a monthly Zoom meeting where we get to talk face to face. Thank you again to everyone who supports me.